a man of precious, and we are here at Federal University of Technology Owerri on a campus book tour on the book Love Does Not Win Election.
Get up, yeah, she's a dancer.
Need your tunes.
More music at ninjaloaded.com.
Flashes with a red car. Cyrus Money Ritz, yeah. No other.
On the author of Love Does Not Win Elections. And now you've changed everything for us. Okay, please, ma'am, can you really speak to the viewers? Tell them what you think. Tell them it's not about sitting down and wishing Nigeria changes. It's about doing some things which will tell them right now.
Sure. I mean, honestly, Nigeria, we have a lot of good people. I mean, I've seen them even here. I mean, smart people who have ideas that I've never thought about myself. So the truth is, yes, we can improve our country, but we cannot do that from the sidelines. We cannot do that by sitting down and complaining. We cannot sit down by just saying, those people. We are the people. We are the ones who are going to have to go take part by not just voting on election day. The thing with problem with elections in Nigeria is that by the time we are voting on election day, 80% of the battle for decent leadership has already been lost because the options that we have are limited. What we need is more people joining the political parties. Let's knock down on their doors. If they don't let us in, we know that means they don't want our votes. Because it's very simple. We want to join your party so that we can be part of what you are doing. If you don't want us, then that means you don't want our votes. Then when we do that, we now move and say, okay, where are the parties that we can belong to that are more open? Or what are the parties that we are creating ourselves so that we can now do the things we say we want to do? How are we recruiting people? We need the younger generation to move away from recruiting on the basis of ethnicity and religion. To be honest, I don't think any viable option for moving Nigeria forward will be successful if it is arranged on, wants Fulani here, wants a Igbo man here. No, we want people with values. We want a hardworking man here. We want a hardworking woman here. We want a man who has shown integrity all his life here. We want a woman who has shown integrity all her life here. We want a young person who has already done a lot in that. We need values. We need to say who are the people that have vision, who are empathetic, who we can hold accountable, who have a track record of excellence. Those are the things we should be organizing around, not against zoning. No, enough of that. And to be honest, I feel like the younger people have a stronger responsibility. It breaks my heart when I go on social media and young people are the ones talking about East, West. Oh, they say somebody stole money. Next thing is, when other people are doing it, nobody said anything. Forget it, these people are not our friends. Look at the pictures of politicians, Igbo, Yoruba, Hausa, Fulani, Ibibio, Ijo. When it's time to share money, they are laughing, they are all friends. We're the ones who are fighting on their behalf. Stop it, we're wasting our time. Thank you for that exposition. Actually, also, you talked about everything you went through in as a female politician who was trying to get or claim a position in Nigerian politics. And we've heard about it and we've read about it in your book. And we're saying, is it worth it as a lady going into politics after everything that one of all have been through? It is worth it. It is worth it. Politics is the most noble profession in the world. We, in Nigeria, we've turned it upside down so that politics is the place where people with nothing better to go. Yes, exactly. We need to reverse that. We need to start telling ourselves, men, women, young children, from an early age, politics is the most noble thing. Why is it noble? Because it is the way through which you advance your society. It's the way through which you decide who governs you. It's the way you decide what policies and what kind of processes govern you. So what is more important than that? Something that affects your well-being from the minute you are born to the day you die. And you don't want to be part of it. We all have to be part of it. What we need to do, understanding the challenges, like we've all listed, we know there are challenges for women. How can we take those challenges away? How can we mitigate those challenges? How can we reduce those challenges so that it's a less oppressive place for women? But the truth is, it's also oppressive for many men. There are many decent men who try to get in, they can't get in. There are many decent women. So what is wrong is the process. How do we change that process?
Ma'am, I want to know, do you still have wishes of running for any position?
Oh, God, I don't know. I think I only run for president right now.
Oh,
but
wow.
I need at least 1 million Nigerians to write me a petition saying this woman must run. Then I'll run.
Oh, wow. And I'm sure after reading your book and listening to you talk, more than 1 million Nigerians are going to write petitions for this. Because we really want people like you who have a changed idea, who want to bring about a revolution in the Nigerian politics. Thank you very much, Mapa, for speaking to us.
The hard work that you do.
Thank you very much. Well, you heard it all from the horse's mouth. It's not about you sitting down and just wishing anything goes, but it's about you having your PVC and going in there and voting the right persons. The right person with the right vision, with the right idea, with the right plans for us, and who can be held accountable. Well, this program was an eye-opener, and I hope you, who's looking at us right now, is going to take the bull by the horn, get your PVC, and vote the right person.